We thank you, Lord, for taking us through another week. We just come to lift the name of the Lord on high. We come to exalt him and magnify him. This song just says, he's all that we need. With the Lord on our side, we can never go wrong. So just clap your hands with us as we sing and lift this praise up unto the Lord. Truly, we love you on today. We exalt your name. There's no one like you. Lift your voice and tell them, you're all.
You're all I need.
Every breath
you breathe through me.
You're all I need.
You're all I need. Let your rivers flow through
me. Come on, tell them, you're all.
You're all I need.
Every
breath you breathe through me.
Lord, you're all.
You're all.
Every breath you breathe, Lord, you're all.
You're all.
before the Lord in prayer. But before we do this, this is not rehearsed. A little bit of Lord, whatever you're doing in this season, don't do it without me. Can we play just a little bit of that before we go into a word of prayer? Truly, he is doing something awesome in this season, in this pandemic season. He's moving. And Bishop said on last night, don't let this season go to waste. He's doing something. He's moving in this season. He's awakening his people. We love him. We're praying more. We're fasting more. And truly, Lord, whatever you're doing in this season, don't do it without me. I just got to move where the Lord is telling me to move here. Before we go into prayer, come on, lift that up and say,
Lord, whatever you're doing in this season, please don't do it without me. Don't do it without me.
Come on, lift your voice and say, Lord,
Lord, whatever you're doing in this season,
come on, please,
please don't do it without me.
Tell him, don't do it.
Don't do it without me.
Tell him, Lord, if you're moving,
Lord, if you're moving.
Your voice, tell them,
please don't do it without me. Don't do it without me.
Someone needs to be saved. Tell them if you're saving,
Lord, if you're saving, saving in this season.
Tell them, please don't.
Don't do it without me.
How many know he's still healing, Lord?
Lord, if you're healing,
someone need a healing, need a touch from the Lord. Someone please don't.
Please don't do it without me. Don't do it without me.
I'm gonna say that again, Lord, if you're healing.
Lord, if you're healing, you're healing in this season.
Tell him,
please don't do it without me.
Don't do it.
Don't do it without me.
Lord, if you're sending a blessing.
Lord, if you're blessing, blessing. In this season,
please
don't do it without me.
Don't do it.
Don't do it without me.
Hey, sing, Lord.
Lord,
if you're saving,
if you're saving, saving in this season.
Oh, please don't do it.
Yeah.
Bring us our word, a word in prayer. Thank
you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord again.
Praise the Lord.
And praise the Lord again. Lord, whatever you're doing, don't do it without me. Hallelujah. Don't do it without me. At this time, we're going to ask A1 to stand.
Thank you.
We want to thank God for our pastor. Thank God for our apostle. Thank God for everybody that's out here watching and that's actually in the church. We want to thank God for being good. At this time, we're going to have a word of prayer. Amen. Let us bow. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for being good to us this day. We thank you for making a way for us this day. Lord, whatever you're doing, don't do it without me, Lord. Oh, God, we thank you for just blessing us to be able to cry out loud to you on this Sunday morning, to be able to give you the praise on this Sunday morning, to be able to lift up our voices unto you, Lord, and give you the ultimate glory, Lord. Lord, bless our pastor, God, as he brings forth the word on this Sunday morning. Bless him from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet, Lord. Bless every word that comes out of his mouth, Lord. Bless everything about him this Sunday, God. Oh, God, we praise you right now, God. Oh, God, bless the service, God. Bless the people that are watching, God. That someone may be filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost right where they're at, Lord. That someone might have a mind to be baptized in your name, Lord. Oh, God, we praise you on this Sunday morning, God, for being good to us once again, God. Because you did not have to do it, God, but you did, Lord. You opened up the windows for us, God. You opened up the heavens for us, God. You poured us our blessings, God. On this Sunday morning, we thank you for it, God. Oh, God, we praise your name forevermore, God. That you keep on doing it for us, Lord, God. You keep on making a way for your people, God. You keep on opening doors for your people, God. But we cry out loud on this Sunday morning to give you the praise, Lord. To give you the honor, Lord, for being good to us, God. Forgive me, oh my God, for doing whatever you have done for us, God. We praise your name right now, God. We lift up your name right now, God. Right where we're at, lift up the name of Jesus, God, because you're worthy for it, God. You're worthy for all praises, God. And we thank you right now, God. Bless our praise team, God. And they sing to you, God. Bless their voices, God. Oh, hallelujah. Bless them right now, God. Bless our musicians, God, as they play for you today, God. Bless each and everything about them, God. Oh, hallelujah. We praise you, God, for being good, God. Thank you for knowing who we are, God, and you, God. And we praise your name forevermore. We give you glory, God. And we give you praise continuously, God. In the name of Jesus, we all pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Right where we're standing, we're going to open up the word to the book of Ecclesiastes, the 3rd chapter. Ecclesiastes, the 3rd chapter, reads, to everything there is a season, a time to every purpose under the heavens, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to keep silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. What profit has he that worketh and that wherein he laboreth? I have seen the travails which God hath given to the sons of men to be exercised in it. He hath made everything beautiful in his time. Also he hath set the world in their hearts, so that no man can find out the work that God maketh from the beginning to the end. I know that there is no good in them, but for a man to rejoice and to do good in his life, and also that every man should eat and drink and enjoy the good of all his labor. It is the gift of God. Amen. I want to thank God for the word that have just been read. Now we're going to turn it over to our praise team.
Sweetest name I know, Jesus, I'll tell it wherever I go, heals the sin sick soul, makes the wounded whole. There's power in his name.
Come on, let's say that again.
Oh, Jesus,
the sweetest
name I know.
Hey,
tell it wherever I go,
and he will
heal the sin sick soul,
and not only that,
makes a wounded whole. There's power in his name.
Jesus, Jesus, may the blind to see. Oh, Jesus, heal the man with leprosy. His name has the power to save and set us free. There's so much power in his name. Oh,
Jesus,
the sweetest name.
The sweetest name I know.
Jesus,
I'll tell it wherever I go.
And he will
heal the sin sick soul.
And not only that,
makes the wounded whole.
Jesus, Jesus, may the blind to see. Oh, Jesus, heal the man with leprosy. His name has the power to save and set us free. There's so much power in his name. Oh,
Jesus,
it's the sweetest name.
The sweetest name I know. Tell it wherever I go,
and he will
heal the sin sick soul,
and not only that,
makes the wounded whole. There's power in his name. Yeah. It's in the name of Jesus. There's so much power in his name. And we talk about power.
There's power.
It's in the name.
There's power in his name.
There's so much power. About love.
There's love.
There's love
in his name.
Unconditional love.
There's love.
It's in his
there's
name.
Love in his name.
And if you need some peace,
there's peace.
God's power.
There's peace in his name.
If you need peace of mind,
there's peace.
God's power.
There's peace in his name.
And if you need deliverance,
there's deliverance.
There's deliverance.
There's deliverance in his name.
Whoa.
Love.
There's love in his name. Unconditional love.
There's
some joy.
There's joy,
joy,
there's joy
in His name.
In His name.
Joy.
There's joy in His name,
and He's got the power,
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 power. Wonder what
He's got power.
Power,
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 power. Wonder working,
living right,
power,
giving right,
power.
That's my Jesus,
power.
That's my King.
Power.
Whatever you want,
power.
Whatever you need,
power.
Ask the Lord,
power.
He'll give it to you.
Power.
Walking right,
power.
Talking right,
power.
Living right,
power.
Giving right,
power.
I need
power.
His power.
Power.
I need
power.
His power.
Power.
Whatever you want,
power.
Whatever you need,
power.
Ask the Lord,
power.
He'll give it to you.
Power.
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 Power. I need it
power.
In the morning.
Power.
I need it
power.
Breathing the breath.
Power.
I need it
power.
I need it
power.
I need it
power.
I need it
power.
He'll pick you up.
Power.
Turn you around.
Power.
Place your feet
power.
On solid ground.
Power.
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 Jesus.
Power.
Jesus.
Power.
Listen, Jesus.
Power.
Jesus.
Power.
Whatever you want.
Power.
Whatever you need.
Power.
Ask the Lord.
Power.
He'll give it to you.
Power.
I gotta have
power.
It. I gotta have it.
Power.
I gotta have it.
Power.
I gotta have it.
Power.
His power.
Power.
I gotta have it.
Power.
His power.
Power.
I gotta have it.
Power.
Kind of power.
Power.
Kind of power.
Power.
He rose
power.
With the power.
Power.
He rose
power.
With the power.
Power.
He rose
power.
With the power.
Power.
Cause God
power.
Got power.
Power.
Cause God
power.
He's got power.
Power.
Whatever you want.
Power.
Whatever you need.
Power.
Just ask the Lord. To
power,
walking right,
power,
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 living right,
power,
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 giving right,
power,
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 power.
I need
power,
His power,
power.
I need
power,
His power,
power.
I gotta have
power.
His power. Ask the Lord, whatever you want, just ask the Lord. I gotta have,
I gotta
have, I gotta have, I gotta have. He'll pick you up, turn you around, place your feet on solid ground. Whatever you want, I gotta have, whatever you want, just ask the Lord. Power,
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 power.
I need His power, I need. Turn you around,
power.
Place your feet
power.
On solid ground.
Power.
I gotta have,
power.
I gotta have,
power.
I gotta have,
power.
His power.
Come on, let's put our hands together. If you know you got power, come on, let's put our hands together. If you know you got power, if you believe in the power, hallelujah, hallelujah. Our God is faithful unto us, and we honor the Lord. So kind to turn with us in Joshua 7. And by the grace of God, we're going to just look at one verse of scripture. And we'll talk as the Lord leads us today. Joshua 7 and in verse number 13. The scripture declares, "Up, sanctify the people, and say, sanctify yourselves against tomorrow. For thus saith the Lord God of Israel, there is an accursed thing in the midst of thee. O Israel, thou canst stand before thine enemies until ye take away the accursed thing from among you." There is an accursed thing in the midst of thee. O Israel, thou canst stand before thine enemies until ye take away the accursed thing from you. By the grace of God and with the help of the Lord, today we'll talk on the subject for just a few minutes. Obedience is the key. Obedience. An unpopular word, but it's backed by demand. Obedience is key. Will you pray with me? Father, we thank you in the precious and in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray, Lord, that you would allow hearts, praise the Lord, to receive the word of God. Hearts have already been conditioned for the word through the songs of Zion, through the playing of music. We ask you, Lord, that you would now allow the word to fall on good ground and allow the word to bring forth fruit that will be fruitful in the proper season. We pray, Lord, even this morning that you would bless our hearts and bless our endeavors. Help us to always lean to you and not to our own understanding. We pray for guidance this Lord's morning. Praise the Lord through the word of God. We pray, O God, for clarity. Hallelujah. We pray, O God, that you would allow your voice to be heard. Allow your power to be felt. Move me out the way, for I'm just merely a vessel. Never am I the source of what thus saith the Lord. We pray, Lord, that you would bless every soul that is watching today. Bless hearts and bless families in the name of Jesus. We pray for keeping power. We pray for strength in this very moment. We pray for families to be knitted together in love and in unity. We pray for the strength of our essential workers working in the tabernacle of God, being faithful unto your holy and divine will. We pray, Lord, that you would keep us from all hurt, harm, and danger, seen as well as unseen. Let the praises of God go forth like never before. Rally us together that we may give you the glory in these last days. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray and we believe. We say amen and amen. Obedience, obedience, obedience is key. Obedience is key. It is this Joshua that is here who is very well known by the grace of God through the historical book of not only Joshua, but he is known through the lineage and through the ministry of his forefather, of his leader and mentor by the name of Moses, raised up under the great leadership and the handiwork that God had given unto Moses. He begins to pull Joshua under his leadership, but for Joshua to be a good leader, Joshua had to be able to have the right spirit to follow. He had to have the ability to follow in the midst of circumstances and situations, even when he did not understand what Moses was actually doing. Not always maybe even agreeing with every thought process of what Moses was doing and could understand what Moses was doing, but yet he humbled himself and would follow the leadership of Moses. It is key to understand that humility is a great prerequisite that we must have if we're ever going to serve in the midst of servitude positions, to serve with other people, and to serve for other people. And to serve people in general, we have to be able to have, hallelujah, humility with us. It's a great attribute to be able to have. And if we cannot humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God, then serving God's people is not a position. And it doesn't matter in which way we serve. You can be the preacher, the teacher, the evangelist. It's not just to those positions, but it is even to leadership and ministry heads, even to musicians and people that lead in some fashion. We have to have a spirit of humility to be able to work with each other. We have to be able to have humility, to be able to hear one another. It can't always be our way. It has to be able to be a collaboration. Hallelujah. And when we have the collaboration, that's when we have this word called unity. When we have unity, we can be like those that were in the Old Testament when they were building the Tower of Babel. Hallelujah. And they said, let us make us a tower and reach unto the heavens. It got God's attention so much that they were so unified that God had to come down and he discombobulated them. He changed their language because they were all, watch this, they were all speaking the same thing. There's something drastic that can happen when you and I have the ability to humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God and to strive to learn to speak the same thing. Hallelujah. It is here that he learns how to speak the same language as Moses. And because of his tenacity, because of his work in the ministry, God begins to unravel his will unto him. God positions him and God touches Moses and told Moses to take Joshua up to the mountain. I need you to prepare to turn the ministry over to Joshua because I am getting ready to glorify him. But what he did it in the midst of the people. Glory be to God. When God wants to elevate, glory be to God. When he consecrates and when God anoints one, he does not just do it in a private manner. While we have to do some work behind the scene privately, God is going to reward us openly. It is here he openly rewards him and he anoints him. Hallelujah. God allows Moses to place the mantle of glory upon him. And it is here that in the first chapter of Joshua that God begins to speak to him and to encourage the young preacher because everybody needs some encouragement. He begins to encourage men and told him to only be strong and very courageous. He tells him that you must observe to do according to all that the law in which Moses, my servant, commanded thee. He tells him to turn not from it. He says, don't go to the right hand and neither to the left. He says that thou may prosper whithersoever that thou goes. He says, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth. He says, but thou shalt meditate. Glory be to God. I feel good here now. Thou shalt meditate therein day and night. Meditate in what? Meditate in what, Sister Keisha? Meditate in the Word of God. Hallelujah. The Word of God. I heard the psalmist declare that the Word it is that I have hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee. It is the Word, the Word, the Word, the Word, the Word that we need to rely on. It is the Word that we need to depend on. It is the Word that we must strive to seek out and seek after. Blessed be the name of the Lord. It is the Word, the same Word that is written, and we know it to be called 66 books of the Bible, but this is the most published book, and it is has been the most purchased book in the history of time. Hallelujah. It is the most read book. However, we must read it and not just read it to say that we read it. We must read it, hallelujah, to strive to get an understanding and to strive to do all that is written therein. I wish I had some people today that they could shout, I love the Word of God. Hallelujah. It's unpopular, but I want to tell you, God has allowed his Word to come back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And make it popular, but it's back by demand. Hallelujah. That's why in the midst of the struggle that we're in now, more people are seeking out the word. More people are wondering, is the day coming where the world is coming to an end? Well, let me share with you, it is coming to an end. Hallelujah. But this is the day that we that are ready, we're waiting for it. Hallelujah. We're waiting for the time that the church can be caught up. Hallelujah. We are believers, and believers, we operate differently. Hallelujah. It's here now, bless the name of Jesus, that Joshua begins to go through the ministry. God begins to elevate him and to utilize him. God shows him how to overcome various things. Praise the Lord. He goes and he does certain works. Praise the Lord. He goes over the Jordan, and while they go over the Jordan, he tells them that let's leave 12 stones reminding them of the 12 tribes of Israel, so that when we come back through, our children can reminisce and we have a story to tell them of how we have overcome. Hallelujah. That's why everybody needs to hold tenaciously to their testimony. Don't let nobody disturb you from your song. Don't let nobody disturb you from something that God has instilled in you. It was just the other day, praise the Lord, I told my wife about a particular song, and she wanted to sing the song, but I really wasn't feeling it. But they sung it and it went to the glory of God. I'm here to tell you, even the best of us misjudge at times. Hallelujah. When God is in something, we need to learn how to take a back seat and let sure that God gets all of the glory. Oh yes, hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's here that God now begins to show him the fear of Israel, that Israel had fear, but he wanted them to know that I am with you. Hallelujah. I need some help this morning. I'm almost about halfway through. Can you just look at somebody? Maybe you're in your kitchen. Maybe you're with your children, but just look at them and tell them that God is with you. Hallelujah. It is here now that they, in the sixth chapter, that it is the siege of Jericho. Hallelujah. God gives them the ability to walk around Jericho. Hallelujah. For 7 days, but the first 6 days they had to walk around Jericho one time, and they had to follow the instructions. They had to obey, to say not a word. They were given the commandment, the edict, the order, the structure to not say anything at all. They don't belch out a word, but yet they follow the planogram. They follow the instructions, and while they walk around, God is doing something so marvelous. Hallelujah. And all of a sudden, God allows them on the seventh day to walk around seven times, and when they walked around the seventh time, he told them to shout, but he did not just tell them to shout a regular shout. He told them to shout with a great shout. Glory be to God. The trumpet sounded. Bless the name of the Lord. They had the priesthood leading the pack. Hallelujah to God. And when they blew the trumpets, they shouted not with the ordinary or the average shout, but they shouted with a great shout. Hallelujah. They shouted so much, hallelujah, that the heavens had to attach itself to the sound of the shout. Hallelujah. And it shouted so much that the walls came crumbling down. Hallelujah. They walked into, hallelujah, and they seized Jericho. They took over, hallelujah, property. God enlarged their territory. Yes. God wants to enlarge our territory through our obedience. He will bless you. He'll bless me. He'll keep you. He'll keep me if we obey what God told us to do. And let me say this. God, I feel a little joy coming now, BC. Hallelujah. God would allow us, hallelujah, to experience some things, but sometimes obeying God means doing something that seems strange. Can I say it again? Being obedient to God means sometimes to doing something that seems to be awkward. To obey God sometimes means to do something that is out of the ordinary. Because his ways are not our ways, and his thoughts are not even our thoughts. His ways are past finding out. He is God, hallelujah. And when God moves us, hallelujah, he'll do something different. How in the world do you think that the man of God, hallelujah, when he lost his axe, and the Bible says that the axe went into the water, hallelujah, but all of a sudden, because he threw a stick in the water, the Bible says when he put a stick in the water, it made the axe head to float. Y'all ain't gonna talk back to me. I said, God, hallelujah, does things differently. Hallelujah. God don't move out of the ordinary. Hallelujah. God does what he wants to do, when he wants to do it, with whom he wants to do it. And some people will be disturbed when God moves you in a great way. Some people want to hold you in a box, and they want you to be who they want you to be, but I got to do what God told me to do. I dare somebody type in this morning, I'm going to be obedient to God. I need you to point at somebody in the church this morning and tell them, obedience is my key. Hallelujah. We're still in the text this morning. It is here now that through the plunging of the struggle, through the plunging, praise the Lord, of coming through, coming through, hallelujah, over the sea. It is here now, hallelujah, they cross through Jericho. Now they come and they find themselves now that where they, hallelujah, have experienced victory, hallelujah. And one of the greatest damnable things and dangerous things that we could ever do is that when we experience victory in something, that we get a little prideful, we get a little arrogant, bless the name of Jesus, we get a little beside ourselves. When the Lord opens up a door for you and I, it is not for us to get prideful and to get lifted up. When God blesses you to sing a song and people comment and people say you did a great job, when you played an instrument and they say I really enjoyed you, when you preached a message and they say, God, hallelujah, that was a word you really preached. We need to make sure, hallelujah, I say it all the time because I believe it, we need to make sure that we don't secretly take the credit, hallelujah, and accredit ourselves and put a stamp of approval on our own back, but we need to say to God be the glory, hallelujah, for without him I can do nothing. Without him we are nothing. Our life is but a mere vapor. And if without God's breath, without his ruach, if he snatches the breath from us, all of us will drop like a paper bag, hallelujah, and we won't be have any life. We will look lifeless. Bless the name of the Lord. That's why we need to be able to remember who hath made us and not we ourselves. I'm in a season in my life. I want to give God every ounce of credit. I want to tell him thank you every day. I do. Hallelujah. That's the season I'm in my life. I want to honor him. When I mess up, I apologize. I want to ask for forgiveness. I want to make sure in this season, if God comes back tomorrow, I want my soul to be right. I'm not going to allow isms and schisms and small minuscule things to hold me back from the kingdom of God. Kingdom is in my view, y'all. How many can you say it this morning that the kingdom is in my view? Hallelujah. I have to be honest with you. The kingdom was not in my view like it is through this pandemic. It shifted my thinking. Hallelujah. Now all I can see, hallelujah, is come quickly, Lord. Hallelujah. Whatever you're going to do, we want to be ready as the church. Hallelujah. And that's why you don't need a pacified word. That's why you don't need a word of pacification. You don't need the preacher to put a pacifier in your mouth and say, God, God, goo, goo, and pat you on the backside. You need a word from God, because the word of God is sharper, is powerful, is sharper than any two-edged sword. That same word, bless the name of Jesus, hallelujah, will cut asunder bone and marrow. Its same word is a discerner of thoughts. Hallelujah. We can't fool God at any time, and we need a strong word, hallelujah, that can pull us out of the pits of hell, that can pull us from the boiling flame of fire. Hallelujah. I dare somebody type in, hallelujah, kingdom is in my view. The kingdom is in my view. If the kingdom is in your view, that means we're going to work it out. That means I'm not going to allow little stuff to hold me back. Hallelujah. I'm not even going to allow other people's thought processes to destroy my peace. My peace is more important than what you may think of me or say about me. Hallelujah. If you don't want no parts of me, you need to just separate yourself from people today. Hallelujah. Love them. You got to learn how to love some folks from a distance. That don't mean that you don't love, but you got to learn how to love them from a distance. Hallelujah. It is here now in Joshua chapter 7 that God, hallelujah, they got a little slightly beside themselves. They go and they seek out this place called Ai, and they come back with a word and says, listen, there's only a few people over there, hallelujah, and we do not need, hallelujah, to even take a bunch of folks with us. Let the men and let the children, let them stay back. We'll go over here and we will take care of business. I'm paraphrasing here, hallelujah, but all of a sudden, hallelujah, when they got over to Ai, the God of their salvation did not allow, hallelujah, them to overtake a few people, hallelujah, because of some disobedience that took place, hallelujah, out of chapter 6. Even though God gave them the victory, there was one man by the name of Achan, hallelujah, that disobeyed and decided, hallelujah, that when he saw the silver, when he saw the shekels of gold, the Bible says, when he saw the Babylonian garments, hallelujah, when he saw, hallelujah, he coveted them and he took them and he put them underneath his tent. Hallelujah. He took the clothes. He took, hallelujah, 200 shekels of silver. He took the gold, hallelujah, and he buried it, hallelujah. And so when they went to the battle, hallelujah, because God was giving them instructions the whole time, and when they got there now, hallelujah, they all saw all of a sudden discover that they lost the battle. Yes, Jesus, the Lord was with them prior, but because of one man's disobedience, hallelujah, it is is important to understand, bless Lord, that one man's sins can affect the others. Don't you know what you do can affect your children? And that's why many of our generations are affected today. Some of us have been raised without fathers. Some of us have been raised without mothers. And you wonder why some people are acting out the way they're acting out. It's because they're lacking something in life. And so sometimes while we are trying to medicate people, hallelujah, at the branch that we're looking at, we see the branch moving and we're trying to medicate them because of the branch. No, we need to pray for them and get to the source of the root. Hallelujah. Stop dangling with branches, praise the Lord, because branches is only a symbol of what's going on down deeper in the root of an individual. And that's why sometimes we need patience one with another. Y'all, I feel like talking this morning. We need patience one with another. We need long suffering one with another. The Bible says to be forbearing one with another. You don't know what somebody else been through. You don't know what I've been through. I don't know what you've been through. That's why we got to love each other. Love them right where they are. You think every person that is on drugs wants to be on drugs? No, hallelujah. Everybody that's addicted to something don't always want to be addicted to something. Sometimes they're crying out for help. Yes, but they cry out in a different way. And so we have to be able sometimes to overlook ignorance. Aren't you so glad that God overlooked our ignorance? I'm talking about this boy this morning. I'm so glad when I was deep down in my sin. Hallelujah. I didn't always do the right thing. I haven't always thought the wrong thing. And can I tell you the truth? Every now and then, some bad thoughts come across my mind. I say, Lord, you got to help me. Hallelujah. Hey, God. Hallelujah. Some people say things to you to try to hurt you. You can feel your flesh working. You feel like you want to do something to somebody. That is real life. Hallelujah. But don't you know, that's why we need the power of the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost, hallelujah, allows you to kill, to mortify the deeds that working in our flesh. Hallelujah. It's here. I got to get out of here, y'all. But it's here that Joshua now he discovers, hallelujah, and God begins to work on him. Joshua falls down to his knees and, hallelujah, he goes into sackcloth and ashes. He goes into a season of prayer. The Bible says that the people's heart melted, and God had moved on Joshua while he was down in prayer, and he told Joshua that you need to get up, and I need you to tell the people, hallelujah, to sanctify yourselves against tomorrow. And what that really means, bless the name of the Lord, to sanctify yourselves, it would suggest that we need to examine ourselves. Hallelujah. And that is a problem not only with church, that is a problem with people in the world today. You may be watching, my brothers and sisters, but I want to tell you, what bothers me is that they will say that church people are hypocritical. No, church people are people from the world. I'm in the church because I need help. I'm not in the church because I got it all together. I'm in the church because I need God to help me. Hallelujah. Hey, so don't think that we in here because we got it all together. That ain't why we in here. We in here because we're trying to get it together. Hallelujah. I wish somebody would shout, I'm working myself. I'm working to get it together. Hallelujah. It is here that he tells him to get up, sanctify the people, and examine yourselves. Sometimes we don't want to take the time out to even acknowledge what we did wrong. Hallelujah. But when you have the ability to acknowledge what you did wrong, strong. You give God the ability to come in, hallelujah, and touch you. When you refuse help, God can't even help you. Hallelujah. You've got to have a willing heart and an open heart to repent and say, Lord, help me. Hallelujah. That's why the Bible says, the day that you hear his voice, harden not your heart as they did in the days of provocation. We've got to come back to God. God wants his children to obey him. He said, the Bible said, if my people, which are called by my name, would humble themselves and turn from their wicked ways. Notice who he was talking to. He said, if my people, he's talking to the body of Christ. In other words, he was saying, we got some wrong ways about us. We need to stop pointing fingers and start looking at our own selves. Examine yourself and see whether or not you are in the faith. Now is not the time to point fingers at everybody else. My question is now, who are you going to blame in this pandemic? Hallelujah. You can't say, well, this ministry is against me. This person's against me. Hallelujah. You at home with the door shut. Now is the time to get our hearts right, to make sure that we love God, to make sure that we're willing to do his word. I heard the Bible say in Ecclesiastes, hallelujah, he says, let us hear, hallelujah, the conclusion of the whole matter. He said, fear God and keep his commandments. Hallelujah. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Hallelujah. It's here now that he told him to get the people up. Examine yourselves, because there is sin amongst you. Hallelujah. There is sin amongst you. And I want to tell the world that is watching today, we got to come out of sin today. We got to come out. I got to shut the book. I can't give you, hallelujah, a prancing word. I can't tell you today to turn around seven times and touch your neighbor. I don't want you to touch nobody. I want you to lay hands on yourself this morning and say, Lord, help me in this season. Hallelujah. Come on and work with me this morning. I want you to lay hands on yourself. Everybody lay hands on yourself and say, Lord, help me in this season. If you can't lay hands on yourself, then you ain't ready to bust a move. Hallelujah. You got to be able that when God gives you a word, that you can take time out and examine yourself and say, you know what? I am not always right, but I want to push that I can be right. Hallelujah. I need God to forgive me. Hallelujah. If God woke you up this morning, if God started you on your way, now is a golden opportunity to take this day and make it an advantage day, a day that where you can tell the Lord, I want to do better. You got to go down on your knees, and even if you don't know how to pray, the Bible says that he will intercede for you. He will come in with moanings and groanings which cannot be uttered. Hallelujah. God is a faithful God. That's why when he told Peter that Satan have desire to have you and sift you as wheat, but Jesus told Peter, I prayed for you. How many know that God is on the throne and Jesus is on the right hand and he's still praying for you? I'm so glad that he prayed for me. And when he said that when you are converted, that when you get delivered, I need you to give somebody a hand up. Everybody don't need a hand out, but there's somebody that needs a hand up. Hallelujah, to bring them where they belong. That's why we need all cultures coming together. We need Mexicans and whites and Caucasians and blacks. We don't need black on black folks, hallelujah, hindering and hurting one another. We need brothers and sisters that can come together. We need men that will work with men. We need women that will work with women. We need to lay aside this foolishness that is me against you and you against me. We got to be unified that his name can be glorified. Can I say it again? We got to be unified that he can be glorified. His name is to be lifted. It's better when we do it together. It is greater when we praise him together. You can pray by yourself and get some results, but the Bible said that where two or three are gathered together in his name, that he would be in the midst. In other words, he is touchable and we are touchable. He can touch us and we can touch him. It's a divine connection when we do it together, but we got to get rid of isms and schisms. Hallelujah to God. We got to work this thing out. We got to work it out. Tell somebody, I'm going to work it out. But God was telling them, I need you to examine yourself, because now is the time. Hallelujah, you lost the battle. You previously had glory, but now you lost the glory. But now what God was trying to do was to get them to come out of Ichabod. Ichabod means the glory of the Lord had departed. They had the strength of the glory, but they lost it through the disobedience. But I thought I would stop by today. God dropped it in my spirit a few minutes ago. I did not study this text, but God put it on my heart about 35 minutes ago and told me to tell the people that obedience is your key. If you're looking for a breakthrough, you're going to have to obey God. You're looking for a brand new job, start obeying God. You need the Holy Ghost, he'll give the Holy Ghost to them that obey him. That's Bible. Yes, Lord. You got to obey the Lord, because obedience means that you are going to follow the strategic plan that has been structured, that is ordered by God. That means the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. And when you delight yourself in the Lord, he'll satisfy every living thing. He'll give you the desires of your heart. But you got to lean on him. You got to get out of your own ways and say, Lord, I want to do your will. I want to sanctify myself. Hallelujah. But when God speaks to you and tells you to examine yourself, you cannot, I want you to type this in, I cannot ignore the signs. Hallelujah to God. How you know you are a drunk? When you take one too many drinks. How you know you are addicted? When you know you can't give it up. You can't ignore the signs and say, I don't need no help. But somebody know they need help today. Hallelujah to God. I know you don't always want to do what you're doing, but I'm telling somebody to come out from among them and be ye separate, saith the Lord. Come out, come out, sons and daughters, wherever you are, come out. We used to play a game a long time ago. It was called hide and seek. Yes, Lord. And in the midst of hide and seek, you would go around and you would duck and dodge. You would hide because you didn't want to be found. They would talk around you and you would giggle a little bit because you knew that they were near you, but you wouldn't say anything. You were playing hide and go seek, but when they came out to seek you, you kept on hiding. But then, hallelujah, that when they knew they couldn't find you, they would say, come out, come out, wherever you are. And you came out, and God is been saying the same thing in 2020. Now is not the time to play hide and seek. You play hide and go seek for too long now. I'm calling my people home. I need my people to humble themselves. Sons, men of God, humble yourself. Don't let your pride get the best of you. Women of God, don't let your egos, because women got egos, don't let it get the best of you. But let's come together in one place, on one accord, and suddenly there shall be a sound. Suddenly, somebody will be healed. Suddenly, somebody will be delivered. When we come together and unite one with another, I need you to tell somebody that God told me to obey. When you heard God the first time, you got to be like Samuel when he heard God, even though he didn't understand the voice. But he got up and he started moving. Now is your time. When you hear God, get up from where you are and start moving. Whatever God tells you to do, do that. God wants to bless you. God wants to strengthen you. God wants to make your way perfect, because obedience is the key. Come on and put those hands together. If you love the Lord, put those hands together. If you love him, if you love him, if you love Jesus, come on, while you're at home, put those hands together. Right in your kitchen, right in your basement, right in your bedroom. Come on, put those hands together. Let's celebrate the Lord, for deliverance is nigh. God is nigh, even in your mouth. To him that knoweth to do good. To him, to her. To him, to her. To him, to her. To you, to me. That knoweth to do good. And don't do it to us. It is sin. God is not pleased. And God wants us to come higher. Everything can't be about a praise break. There's got to be a moment, a season in our life where chains are broken, where fetters come off. If we don't have a deliverance ministry, then we don't have a ministry. Woo! Hey, glory be to God. If we don't have a deliverance ministry, then we don't have ministry. God is not about the cutesy stuff. He's not about six steps over here and some kind of little fancy dance. That ain't God. God is about salvation. He means business. And he wants somebody to make a conscious decision today that I'm tired of playing with my soul. I want to do that which is right. Yes, it may be difficult, but I want to tell you, it's doable. If God has granted you another day of life and health, oh, then you can do it. You know why? That means that he is still with you. I'm here because he's still with me. Yeah. We're not here because we did everything right. We're here because he's still with us. Glory be to God. And he has equipped all of us. So what I'm really saying is, time is out for excuses. You can't keep blaming what your mother did 50 years ago. You can't keep talking about what your father didn't do 25 years ago. Let me tell you, you can't continue in that vein. My father wasn't always there. Had an opportunity to talk with somebody, one of the deacons, matter of fact, just the other day, and we were talking about fathers and issues and how we were raised up, and my daddy wasn't there. But let me tell you, I am a grown man now, and I can't keep talking childish things. After a bit, if we need help, we need to seek out help. Whether that is counseling from a preacher, counseling from your pastor, or whether that is external counseling, or sometimes you just need somebody that is seasoned in the church, that won't judge you, but that will listen to you. Somebody that God will lead you to, that won't expose your business, that won't talk about your stuff. There are people like that that you can trust. Trust me, I know a few in this church that will hear you out and won't pass judgment. Won't look at you crooked-eyed. Won't judge you because of something that you're doing. Let me tell you something. We all need the Lord's help. Some people's business is exposed. Some of it is secret. But regardless of if it's exposed or if it's in secret, guess what? We're still all in the same boat. You know why? Because we all still need God's help. But what that does is you think because somebody else is exposed, you want to talk about theirs, but that ain't of God. We need to come back and obey what God has told us to do. God told them, get rid of the accursed thing. And when you get rid of the accursed thing, I'm going to give you the glory back. They got out of Ichabod. Glory be to God. And what happened was God told him to kill not only Achan. I told you earlier that one person's sin can affect others. They not only killed Achan, but they killed everything that was attached to him. They destroyed everything he took, and they killed his family. Bless the name of Jesus. What will our next decision be? We got to think about it. We gotta pray about it. You don't just act out of emotions. While and yet we all have emotions in us, men and women. Some may be a little more emotional than others, but all of us have feelings and emotions. But God don't want us to act out of our emotions. We've got to think. Thank you, Elder Travis. We gotta think with God. We got to walk with God, talk with God before you make the next decision that could alter your life. Glory be to God. Hear God and keep his commandments. I want to pray with you. I want to pray with you before we go, because God is up to something. We love you. We thank God for your persistence, and I want to tell you, regardless of how long you've been saved and folks don't know certain things about you, I want to tell you God is there with open arms to help you, like he's there with open arms to help me. We can't make this race without the Lord. God loves us with the everlasting love. Therefore, with loving kindness has he drawn us. He loves us. Will you be so kind and bow with me as we talk to the Lord? Father, it is in the precious, in the most noble name of Jesus Christ that we come. Glory and honor belongs to you, and power comes from you. We thank you for the word that you have allowed on this great Lord's morning. Thank you for the songs of Zion. We pray, Lord, that every aspect of the service that we strive to render according to your will, that it will benefit somebody that's watching. Benefit my brother. Benefit my sister. Benefit even me. Strengthen us one by one and name by name. Father, even now in the name of Jesus, we pray for help. We pray for divine help. We pray for mental help. We pray for physical help. We pray, hey, for emotional help. We pray in the name of Jesus that you would keep us, that you would preserve us, that you would mold us, that you would shape us, that you would make us the sons and the daughters that you've called us to be in these last and evil days. Thank you for the power of the Holy Ghost. We pray for a fresh anointing. We pray for the fall of the fresh Spirit of God, that it would rest upon us, your people. We pray in the name of Jesus that you would allow hearts to come closer to the cross. Hallelujah. For one plant, one water, but God, we need you to give the increase. Speak to us. Nothing moves without you knowing about it. Nothing moves except you allow it. We pray, Lord, that you would work on us. Hallelujah. And work in us both to will and to do of your good pleasure. Sanctify us and purge us with hyssop. We shall be clean. Wash us. We shall be whiter than the snow. Father, lastly, we ask you to please forgive us. Forgive us of all our iniquities, and we ask you to blot out our transgressions. We ask you to remember our sins no more, to throw them into the depth of the sea. If we have wronged anybody, help us to get it right. We apologize to you, Lord. Forgive us, and we ask you to give us strength to go back and beg pardon with that person. Help us to get it right before you come back. Help us to lay aside every weight and the sin which can and doth so easily beset us, but help us to run this race with patience. Hallelujah. For you are the author and the finisher of our faith. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray and we believe. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you today, you that are looking, watching. We love you. If there's somebody that needs to be baptized, if there's somebody that requests prayer, please let us know. DM us. We're willing to baptize. We're ready to baptize. Praise the Lord. We're willing to pray with you. We have people that are willing and ready to pray with you and to pray you through, that you may receive the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. They're going to come back and they're going to sing a selection, praise the Lord. But I want to ask you, while they're singing this selection, that you would take this time to prepare to sow a seed, to bless the house of God. If God has been faithful unto you, praise the Lord. If God has been gracious and good to you, I want you to, amen, to sow a seed. You that can know how to sow a seed, praise the Lord. You can follow the push pay there. Amen. Follow the app. Amen. You can use the app right there on Facebook Live. For those that are tech savvy, you can text UCOJCA to 77977. God bless you. May the Lord be with you and with me in Jesus' name. We turn you to the hands of praise and worship. Something about the
There's something about the name Jesus. It is the sweetest name I know. Oh, how I love the name Jesus. Oh, how I love the name Jesus. It is the sweetest name
I know.
I know.
Say something about the name.
Something about the name Jesus.
Oh, there's something about your name.
Something about the name Jesus.
Oh, I know.
It is the sweetest name.
I know.
I know.
Oh, how I love.
Oh, how I love the name Jesus.
Oh, how I love you, Lord.
Oh, how I love the name Jesus.
It is.
It is the sweetest name.
Oh, I know.
I
Come on, let's
know.
Sing that one more time. There's something about.
Something about the name Jesus.
Oh, yes, it is.
There's something about the name Jesus.
It is so sweet.
It is the sweetest name
I know.
I know.
Come on, say how you love it.
Oh, how I love the name Jesus.
Oh, how I love you, Lord.
Oh, how I love the name Jesus.
Say it is.
It is the sweetest name
I know. Come on, help me sing, I know.
I know.
Say, I know.
I know.
Oh, yes, I do. I know.
I know.
Oh, there's something about the name.
Something about the name Jesus.
It is so sweet.
Something about the name Jesus.
He's a comforter.
It is the sweetest name
I know.
I know.
How I love.
Oh, how I love the name Jesus.
Oh, how I love his name.
Oh, how I love the name Jesus.
It is so sweet.
It is the sweetest name
I know.
You do.